My name is Christopher Schell. I'm from Coeur d'Alene, Idaho, and I'm rolling with Legacy. I'm not a man. I have a lot of family here in Missoula. They've been waiting to watch me for like almost 2 years. So I'm hoping Bricks thinks he's going to make it to the next fight next week and the one after that. He's got to make it through one of the toughest Northwest fighters right here in Missoula. So he's going to have to put on a show. This ain't going to be easy.
All right, on to bout number 8, ladies and gentlemen. This is the last amateur fight of the show.
And this is a very, very drawn crowd for this fight here. Tom Blixt is somewhat of a local amateur legend here around here in Missoula in the Lolo area. His fighter, Chris Schell, has got 11 fights under his belt, 6-5, and he's just an all-out scrappy guy. Kind of trains a little bit of everywhere over in Idaho there. I know he trains somewhat with Legacy MMA and then has some different camps he floats around to. I'm kind of expecting a very good fight here, maybe a brawl.
I hope so. Two-ton Tommy Blixt is undefeated in his MMA career, 5-0. Chris Schell, 6-5. He's coming into the cage tonight with significantly more experience. This crowd getting super, super excited for Tommy Two-Ton Blixt.
Two-Ton Tommy Blixt, fighting out of Missoula, Montana for Sakura Warrior Arts and Bitter Rift Jiu-Jitsu.
So right now I'm 5-0 in all my fights. I've submitted my guy. I'm a finisher. I finish all my fights. And, you know, that's how I see this fight going. I'm going to finish it.
That's great to hear. This is going to be a very, very good fight. Do you know anything about either of these fighters?
I know that Blixt is a hometown favorite, and a lot of people are cheering for him.
That's very true. Looks like Mr. Blixt is getting ready to enter the cage here. I'm kind of getting excited for this fight. This is the last amateur bout we will have of the night. It looks like a very good one.
Two-Ton Tommy Blixt. The fans are going crazy for Two-Ton Tommy Blixt.
Mr. Blixt doesn't look like he's got a pound of fat on him. Chris Schell looks to be in very good spirits. He's kind of ready for this fight. It looks like he's in very, very good spirits.
Tom Blixt ready to fight. Chris Schell ready to fight. These are very, very big men, 185 pounds. The middleweight division. 5-0, two-time Tommy Blixt.
I do have to say, announcer Joey's doing a fantastic job today. I know he does a lot of MMA events, especially for Brian Dietz and Fight Force, who I'd like to thank very much. He's had a little bit of a helping hand in on this show, and Brian Dietz's support, that is very good, and we'd like to definitely give him a shout out here and thank Brian Dietz personally. Mr. Blixt has got quite the following. He's got a large portion of this crowd cheering for him right now.
All right.
Last amateur fight of the night.
Last amateur fight of the night. Two-Ton Tommy Blixt, middleweight division. Here we go. stalking each other, looking for the opening. Oh, Blixt landing hard shots.
Some very hard uppercuts. These boys are not even hesitating. Mr. Schell looks like to be pressing, and Tommy was catching him with some hard
uppercuts. Oh, he got beat in the body by Tom Blixt.
Mr. Schell's trying to fight back. He didn't quite give up. He did get dropped there, but he still hasn't stopped moving. He is definitely trying to move around and stay out of it. Mr. Schell was definitely hurt there for a second, but wow, what a great start to this fight. Tommy's got him in side control here.
Two-time Tommy's Blixt in a very advantageous position right now. Chris Schell looking to stay in the fight, trying to survive. Tom Blixt still looking to land the big shot to end the fight. Chris Schell trying to survive.
I'm really surprised he survived that first fury from Mr. Blixt there. Tommy kind of dominated that for a minute there, and Chris kept fighting back.
Tom looking to tie up the arms.
Chris throwing some strikes from the bottom here. Now, do strikes from the bottom, do they really count for much? Do they hurt? How does that go about there, Mr. Bersier?
Not necessarily. There's not a lot of power. You can't generate a lot of damaging power from the bottom. It's a lot of times, a lot of fighters will stay busy on the bottom so the referee doesn't stop the fight. If they're a little bit busy on the bottom, the top guy will try and look to move his position and hopefully offer some space or a way out for the guy on the bottom.
So a strike from the bottom is more of a point score, I guess, or to look pretty, or is it just a waste of energy? Do the judges even look at something of that nature?
Not necessarily. It's the guy on the bottom has to try and find a submission or get out of the bad position that he's in. Right now it looks like two-ton Tom is going for some sort of a head and arm triangle choke. If you're not, that's the end of the round. Chris Schell survived the round.
Chris Schell survived that round. That just shows the heart and character of this gentleman here. Been a good fight so far. I think Tommy definitely dominated that round, but kudos to Christopher Schell there for hanging in and getting to round two. One thing I will say, Leo, is that I've noticed in these amateur fights, even if a particular fighter dominates one round, is it a true statement to say that a fighter can always come out in the second and take the fight in control?
The fights?
We have fun.
We are having a great time. What do you think of Revolution Cage Combat?
We have a fair comp.
So what do you think of Revolution Cage Combat here at the Adams Center?
It's
give us your
wonderful
input.
I absolutely love it. Great sound system, everything's wonderful.
Great atmosphere.
Yeah,
great. Lovely people. Ladies.
Getting ready to start round number two, ladies and gentlemen.
Tom Blixt looks a little bit, looked at a little bit more win than Christopher Schell does.
Cut that out.
Chris Schell looks a little bit spent in there. He's breathing pretty heavily. His eyes are pretty heavy in there. So we'll kind of see what comes about here. Chris is kind of backpedaling to start this round.
Tom Blixt looks ready.
Chris kind of swinging haymakers. You know, if he is tired, he might be just trying to go for a KO.
Tom Blixt is hurt. He's going down.
Tom
piece. Tom Blixt is hurt. This is what us fighters in the fight game call.
Oh, here we go.
Tom Blixt goes up.
Chris Schell is coming back.
Oh, Tom Blixt is hurt. Tom Blixt. The referee is about to stop the fight. Tom Blixt.
Oh, he's in full mount. Christopher Schell is in full mount. He is unloading an arsenal upon Tom Blixt now.
The fight is over.
The fight is over.
The referee has seen enough. Oh, Tom Blixt. He doesn't realize the fight was over. He tried to get on top. The fight has been stopped by the referee.
What a great fight. And it just goes to exactly what I was telling you, Leo.
Tom Blixt.
Any round can decide a fight. Tom Blixt completely dominated the first round, and Christopher Schell comes out with just cannons ablazing on him and catches him a couple times there.
In this weight division, with guys this big, all it takes is one shot to change the tide of a fight. Unfortunately for Tom Blixt, he now has a loss to add to his undefeated record.
I will have to say, this is one of the best amateur cards I've ever seen in the state of Montana, possibly in the Northwest.
Absolutely.
Missoula, Montana, these are two tough SOBs in this cage tonight. Take it down to stop the monkey fighters in here.
Chris Schell and two-time Tommy Blixt. What a great fight. What a great fight. Christopher Schell. Out of Legacy MMA, out of Coeur d'Alene, the Legacy MMA fight team has done a fantastic job this evening.
You know, something that I'm just sitting here thinking as they're announcing Christopher Schell as the winner. Is it more pressure to win in front of loads of your friends and family in your hometown? Or is it more pressure from being an out-of-towner?
Absolutely. There's so much pressure to fight in front of your friends and your family and people that you know every day. They're waiting, they're watching you. There's so much expectation. It adds pressure to the fight. When you're coming from out of town to fight, you don't really care. The fighter's mentality is like, I don't know these people. I'm here to kick ass, crunk my paycheck, get the hell out of here. So there's no pressure. Revolution Cage Combat, baby. That's the end of the amateur fights. We'll be back with the professional portion of the card.